Carbon emissions, CO2. You've heard of it, you know it warms the planet, but did you know that this dress is literally made from carbon emissions? Yep, that's exactly what one biotech startup is doing. They're capturing carbon emissions that would normally be released into the atmosphere, warming the planet, and instead converting it into ethanol, which is then processed into one of the components used to make polyester. And voila, a dress is created. And don't think these are some soot-covered dresses better suited for a chimney sweep. Nope, these dresses are actually quite fashionable. You might be saying, wait, how can these be made of carbon emissions? How is that even possible? And perhaps you're asking, how can I get my hands on one? Well, stick around, because that's what we're checking out in this week's episode. How are carbon emissions being captured? Why make clothing out of them? And how does this process help in fighting the climate crisis? Most importantly, we'll talk to that one group that's upcycling all of this into this. This is Jennifer Holmgren. She's the CEO of Lanzatech. That's the biotech startup we mentioned earlier. And Jennifer's on a mission to reduce our global carbon emissions while making really cool products that we use every day, including these dresses. Here's Jennifer.
Our goal is to make sure that we put carbon in a circular economy and we reuse it over and over again, rather than dumping it into the air or into our oceans.
And after more than 15 years of technology development and scaling up, Jennifer and Lanzatech believe they've got the solutions needed to lead the way into a new circular carbon economy. Using those solutions and some creative collaboration with clothing companies, they've created a collection for one of retail's largest brands that incorporates fabrics made with carbon emissions.
We're making products that are identical and complete replacements. And that's actually one of the cool things, right? Because if you can do that, then people don't have to change the entire rest of your manufacturing cycle to be able to use it.
But how do carbon emissions become clothing? Good question. Let's take a look. The journey starts at a steel mill, where instead of coming out of the chimney or smokestack as greenhouse gases, the carbon emissions are captured. Once that CO2 is captured, it is pumped into a bioreactor, which has bacteria swimming all through it. And right when the carbon makes its way into the bioreactor, the bacteria eats it up instantly, converting it into ethanol. Then the ethanol is recovered, cleaned, and shipped to India Glycols Limited, which is a separate company in, you guessed it, India. There, it's converted into monoethylene glycol.
That's the building block of polyester.
Exactly. Thanks, Jennifer. So then that monoethylene glycol building block is processed into a low-carbon polyester yarn by a third company, Far Eastern New Century, in Taiwan. Then you've got your polyester fibers, and the rest is really no different than making clothes not from carbon emissions. Apparel companies and their supply chains use that polyester yarn to make the final pieces of clothing. Whew, that's a mouthful. Still with me? Think of it like a brewery where yeast turns sugar into alcohol in steel tanks. Lanzatech uses bacteria to ferment pollution into ethanol. The entire process from start to finish takes about 4 months to complete. Now, before we go on, let's pause for a quick lesson on today's polyester. You probably already know that polyester is basically a plastic material, and you might already know that plastic comes from petroleum. It's basically made from oil. So this process from Lanzatech not only captures and makes use of emissions that would normally pollute the planet, it also lowers the need to extract more fossil fuels from the ground to create new polyester. Okay, back to the show. So now you've got your dress. It's made out of captured carbon emissions. It's looking good. But can those emissions ever escape the dress and find their way into our atmosphere? Jennifer says, not likely.
So we've prevented it from entering the atmosphere because now it's locked away in that dress. So unless you burn the dress or you decompose the dress in some way, which you're not going to do, that it's locked in.
How neat is that? Lanzatech promotes a carbon-smart circular economy where carbon is locked into the material cycle and consumers can choose where their carbon comes from.
We have the ability to give consumer the choice. Does somebody want to wear a recycled carbon dress, or do they want to wear a dress that was made from petroleum? And that's what we're trying to create, a world where people have a choice of where their carbon comes from.
Why are Lanzatech and clothing brands doing all this? Well, as you might have seen in recent years, the climate crisis is having major impacts on our planet. From extreme weather events, wildfires, severe droughts, and heat waves, it's affecting everything from crop production, disruption of habitats, rising sea levels, the list goes on. According to the Natural Resources Defense Council, or NRDC, the average global temperature in the past 50 years has increased at the fastest rate in recorded history. All of which is the direct result of us humans emitting a lot of greenhouse gases, mostly carbon, into our atmosphere and causing the global temperature to rise. According to a 2021 report from the UN, global emissions are expected to rise 16% by 2030, compared to 2010 levels. That puts the world off track for the 45% cut in emissions the climate scientists say is needed to meet the Paris Agreement's goal of limiting global warming to 1.5 degrees Celsius above pre-industrial levels. That means if we don't take immediate action, the consequences will be major. With heat trapping carbon in the atmosphere causing more devastating effects, there will be no turning back. Yikes. But not only that, a report from the New England Journal of Medicine also suggests that the rising global temperatures will lead to many more deaths and could force 100 million people into extreme poverty by 2030. So what can be done? Well, to start, Lanzatech has a goal over the next couple of years to prevent 1 million tons of CO2 from being emitted and instead turning it into products. That's like taking over 197,000 passenger vehicles off the road for 1 year. So far, the company has produced over 24 million gallons of low carbon intensity ethanol and has prevented 120,000 tons of CO2 from being emitted into the atmosphere. They hope that someday, everything that is used and bought will come from re-recycled carbon, not fresh fossil carbon.
I would like people to understand this, that all these things are possible, that we need to just be working on technology, scaling technology, and that we need partners like Zara to get support from consumers so that they continue to try to lead a change.
The company hopes to create future refineries and convert the ethanol in one location instead of shipping it out across the world, further cutting down on their own emissions. They also aren't stopping at clothing and plan to produce all sorts of products using their tech. Everything from bottles, aviation fuel, shoes, and rubber tires. So that's about it. Carbon emissions are captured and converted into ethanol through fermentation, which is then converted into low-carbon monoethylene glycol and turned into a low-carbon yarn, which is then used to make fabric. All of this helps in limiting the release of carbon into our atmosphere. Cutting back is super important to offsetting global warming. So, what are your thoughts on this emerging tech? Would you wear clothing made out of CO2? How else are you helping stop the climate crisis? Let us know in the comments below. Hey, me again. Thanks for watching. We hope you enjoyed hearing about this innovation in the manufacturing industry. Hopefully a lot more brands will take on this and similar initiatives in their future collections. But we're Now This Earth, and we can't do an episode about polyester without mentioning microplastic. Polyester and other synthetic materials shed microfibers, which in these materials is just another word for microplastics. A whole nother issue we need to be aware of. There's no silver bullet when it comes to this stuff, and this example just goes to show we need even more companies coming forward with creative solutions to tackle the climate crisis. So what do you think?